It's time for another installment of The Basics, and on today's show, in sticking with the Star Trek CCG, I want to talk about a strategy that some people employ that really doesn't work, and it's called the Strength in Numbers strategy, and I'm going to explain how that works on today's show and why you shouldn't use it. So I've set up a simple space line of 7 cards. I'm using a Federation outpost and 3 of my lower Federation ships to illustrate how strength in numbers works. And I used to have a friend in my group, who surprisingly wasn't Josh this time, so I can't plug him on this episode, who used this strategy, and it was a losing strategy almost every time. I've also heard of it being used at tournaments. I've never seen it at any of the tournaments I've been to, but some people still employ this strategy, and it's a bad idea. Basically, strength in numbers works like this. You have 3 ships out from your draw deck, and it might be all 3 ships in your deck, unless you have one in your side deck. And what you would be doing after they are staffed, you would be using their range to move them one by one to each space line location and keeping them with each other. So instead of splitting them up, so say for example, maybe sending the Britain down to this end to go after that mission with its crew, or the Phoenix to go ahead and use up its range to get to another space mission and score those points, you're keeping your 3 ships together at the same space line location. Oh man, where to begin? This is a terrible strategy because when you think about it, you have 3 ships that could be doing other things. They're all at one space line location, all with their crews and any equipment that they might have with them. They're not doing anything useful. You don't need 3 ships and 3 crews to attempt one mission. As I've mentioned on previous episodes, if I have multiple ships out on my space line, I might have 2 of them rendezvous if I have a combat situation that looks like it's going to happen, but otherwise I'll have 1 in reserve and 2 will be off doing separate missions to try to score me points in different ways. Putting all of your ships together, and this falls under the all of your eggs in one basket approach, it's disastrous. The friend that I talk about that used to do this, the time it took him to get all of his ships to certain locations at the same time and then attempt missions, we were already at other points in the space line scoring points. We would be up 2 missions on him by that point, if not more. Especially if your opponents are playing a faction that has cloaking technology. You sitting at one location is useless. They're just going to float past you, reappear somewhere, score points if they can get past the dilemmas, and you are going to lose. The only time in the Star Trek CCG that it makes sense to have multiple ships at one location is either if you're aware of a combat situation, as I mentioned, or if you're playing against a Borg deck and you want to try a preemptive strike, which, as I've mentioned before, doesn't always work. But other than that, the strength in numbers strategy is terrible. Never use this strategy. I'm surprised that people still do this, and just wow. Don't even bother. Now, that being said, the very last time I saw that strategy employed in a game that I was participating in, my opponent was using a weak Bajoran deck, and he massed 3 Raiders and a Freighter trying to stop 2 of my Romulan Warbirds, which were so juiced we went right through them. Other than that, never use that strategy. Don't do it. It's terrible. Have a great day, everybody.